Hi all, welcome in the AWS Solution Architect Certification Exam Dump. So today I'm with a new question, and that question is related to that security group and network SQL. And this is very interesting, and it is my favorite question because it covers almost 80% concept of AWS VPC components. So let's jump on the question. A company hosts a popular web application. The web application connects to a database running in a private VPC subnet. So I will mark the hints here. So first hint is like that it is running in a private VPC. So our database is in the private VPC subnet. The web service must be accessible only to customer on SSL connection. So it needs to be accessed by using the HTTPS protocol. The RDS MySQL database server must be accessible only from the web server. So third condition is like that the database should be accessible from web server only. So I have already marked the hint point, and the diagram is very simple. If we are trying to visualize the question, so the below is the diagram. User is trying to access through the HTTPS protocol, and this EC2 instance is the subnet, and it is a web server. Web server must connect to the database, but other cannot connect to the database. It is in the private subnet. So now I am jumping to the answers, but one thing, I will cover most of the concept of VPC component, and I will include security details about the security group, NSEL, and other things. So I will try to find out that this video is useful for you to find out the correct answer or not. And once video is finished, then I will I am just hoping like that you will provide the answer in the comments. So just for the visualization purpose, I am having this diagram that user is trying to connect the EC2 instance through the HTTPS protocol, and database is in the private subnet, and web server is trying to connect the web server, database. So I am jumping to the options, create a network SQL. So I am just highlighting the main component which is generally being used while we are connecting to EC2 instances or RDS instances through the network SQL or security group. So I'm just highlighting the components. This is the network SQL, and there is a word used, inbound and outbound. So it's very simple, like they are connecting through the HTTPS, and this is the inbound, and database is providing the access to EC2 server and providing the output. Then it is trying to say like that place both database and web servers on the same subnet. So if it is same subnet, then it will be a private subnet, and it will create the more complication to access the web server by the user. So right now, as per the below diagram, just assume like that EC2 server web server is not in the same subnet, and it is never advisable that you should have the web server inside the private subnet where database is also running. So that answer is wrong. Just I'm just updating that answer is wrong, but you can evaluate this A answer again. B is open an HTTPS port on the connect security group. So there is the one more point, security group, that is the component for web server, and 0.00 is the source. So we will discuss about that, what is the meaning of 0.00. Open the MySQL port on the database security group and attach to the MySQL instance. Set the source to web server security group. So how we can set the source to the web server security group? So that we will also see it into the next slide. Create a network SQL on the web server subnet and allow the HTTPS inbound. So this is the same. Open the MySQL port on the security group for the web server and set the source. So okay, so I have highlighted the main component, and we will see the next slide. And after that, once everything is clear to us, we will try to find out the answer. So this is the design for our web server. So this is the web server, and this is the database server. So you can see that this is the public subnet and this is the private subnet. And this is the internet gateway. So internet gateway is used to accessible from the outside, and this will route the call to the router, and router will redirect the call to the public subnet, so where the web server is running. So for higher scalability, we can have the multiple web servers with the different IP address, and these are the elastic IP address, public IP address, which are associated with that router. And we can also enhance this diagram with the auto scaling, and we can have the ELBs, elastic load balancer. So internet gateway will provide only the one static IP address, which will redirect the call through the router, and the web server, which is the free, will take the call and will fulfill the request, and it will send the response. Whenever web server wants to communicate with the private subnet where the database is running, it can be easily leveraged by using the net gateway. So net gateway provide a facility where the web server can communicate with the database server via the router. It cannot directly communicate. So here we are having the custom route table. So it is configured into the router, and this public subnet having this route table, where you can see that destination is any kind of destination, and we are having the internet gateway is associated in this route table. Now we are having the main route table, and here we have mentioned like that the target is net gateway ID. So if any request is coming from here through the net gateway, database server will try to fulfill the request and will send the response. It is the simple diagram, and which is very common adopting into the industries, that using the net gateway you should communicate with the database server, and you should have this entry as a target, that net gateway ID. That net gateway ID can only communicate to the database server, and this will be processed or passed through the router only. But here in the option, it is nowhere mentioned about that you should use the net gateway. So there is another design which I will discuss, but it is required for you to understand how the net gateway works, and it is the common practice you should use the net gateway rather than using the security group for connectivity with the database server. Now this is the main VPC components, this is the subnet, this is the route table. So route table is just I discuss about this, and when it is like 0.00 means it is allowed for the all IP addresses. So like here, if you are doing the auto scaling, then new web server can have the different elastic IP address, so you no need to change again and again the custom route table. You just mention it 0.0, and then it will go to the database server and it will fulfill the request. Then there is elastic IP. Elastic IP is nothing but a public IP. I know already you are aware, so I will not take more time. Elastic network interface I will cover in the one more videos. I will link it here. And internet gateway is useful for accessing from the outer side. So internet gateway is providing the one more layer where the user will interact by using the IP address. There is a customer gateway, which I will discuss with you later. And VPN connectivity is useful when you are trying to connect from the on-prem to cloud, so you can have a secured connectivity, and we can use the VPN, virtual private network. It's not there in this diagram, but I think it is there in the next diagram. I will discuss more about the virtual private gateway. VPC peering is useful when you are having one more VPC and you want to peer it, like it is in the another account, or it is not in the another account, it is in the another zone, in the multi availability zone. If you are having the one more private subnet, then you can do the VPC peering, private or public, then you can do the VPC peering. So I will include the video, and I will attach the link so that you can link that, you can have the more detail about the VPC peering. VPC endpoint is very useful when you do not want to connect with net gateway by communicating with S3 kind of storage. So you can use the VPC endpoint, and it is very reliable and fast. And it is a good practice that you should have the VPC endpoint for connectivity with your subnet. Net gateway, just I included a few minutes before. And these are the more details about, these are the main components I have categorized, like networks, subnet, route tables, router, elastic IP addresses, ENI, internet gateway, egress only internet gateway. These are the VPN connection. It is generally used when you are connecting your VPC from the on-prem. And this is the customer gateways, VPN connectivity for the reliable and secured connection. Virtual private gateway, VPC peering. If suppose you are having two different VPCs, then you can connect with by using the VPC peering API. Endpoints are nothing but VPC endpoints. This one, which I just discussed, like how you can communicate with the S3 storage. And net gateway is the same one. This is the net gateway where you want to communicate with the private subnet. And security is the network ACL and the security group. So we will talk more in detail about these two securities. So here you can see that through the internet gateway, we are getting call into the router, but it can also come from your on-prem infrastructure, and it can be called through the virtual private gateway. So virtual private gateway is useful when you want to communicate from your on-prem to VPC cloud. So the router can get call from the two different interfaces, and it will redirect the call to the route table. There is a network ACL which is called as the second defense layer, and the first defense layer is always the security group. So network ACL will filter out your request. If it is a valid request, then only it will pass to the security group, otherwise it will discard. And the security group is based on that instance level, where the network ACL is based on your subnet level. So suppose in this subnet you are having the multiple EC2 instance, then each EC2 instance can have its own security group, but there will be only one network ACL. So this is the second defense layer. And here it is the same applicable for the private subnet. So private subnet can have the multiple instances and can have the individual security group, but there will be only one network ACL. So we'll read more about that, what is the major difference between the network ACL and the security group. But right now you can just think about that instance level. You can define the security by using the security group, but you cannot do it by using the network ACL. This is the main difference. So here there is a one more diagram where in the right hand side there are the multiple EC2 instances which having the individual security group, but there is only one network ACL, and it's own having its own routing table, that subnet based. So I'm jumping to the another diagram. So this is saying like that if suppose you are having security group for database, then you can define that on which port your database is running. For an example, you are having Tomcat, you can define 8080, and you can mention like that only specific IP address services can use can access my database. So in this condition you can define the IP address, but here in this diagram you can see we are having the multiple elastic IP addresses. So you cannot define all the elastic IP addresses here in the security group of database. So just consider this, it is the DB security group. And in DB security group, you cannot keep on defining the multiple elastic IPs, because if it is auto scaling, then you will get a new elastic IP address and it will not be able to communicate with a database. So there is one more option is that you can click it here and you can define, you can map with security group of this subnet. So in this diagram you can see that you are having the multiple EC2 instances, but there is one security group, and this security group can map to this one, this source. So if I am jumping in this diagram, so you can see that without using the net gateway, because it is not without using the net gateway, you can communicate with your database server by using the security group, and you can define the security group in as a source in the security group of database server. And yes, you have to mention the port number. And web server can be accessed when you are saying that only it is applicable through the SSL protocol. So in the security group of public subnet of web server, you can just mention like that it is applicable only for this port, and you can define the specific port of security group is applicable for SSL. So I have clarified all your doubt, and I think you can judge what is the correct answer. You can find the correct answer from these options. So it's I will hope like that you can mention into the comment sections what should be the correct answer of this question. And hope you liked this video. Thanks a lot.